Crabgrass is a summer annual weed and is one of the most persistent and commonly found weeds in home lawns. The two most common species invading lawns and landscapes across the U.S. are large crabgrass and smooth crabgrass. Control and management of the two species is the same, so no need to worry about differentiating between the two. The first step to reducing crabgrass infestations is to maintain a healthy, vigorous lawn. In addition to proper fertilization and irrigation, it's important to follow the 1/3 mowing rule. By removing no more than 1/3 of the plant's canopy in any single mowing, enough leaf area remains to capture sufficient sunlight needed for your turf to thrive. In turn, you're left with a thick, vigorous lawn that is less susceptible to stress, disease, and encroachment from weeds. Healthy turf grass competes with the weeds, robbing them of the sunlight and nutrients that are essential for their survival. For your planter beds, applying a thick layer of mulch will help deter the establishment of new crabgrass seedlings. You can help prevent crabgrass seed from growing in the first place by using a chemical pre-emergent application of dithiapyr, which is the active ingredient in Dimension, prodiamine, found in Barricade, or pendimethalin, the active ingredient in Pendulum. It's important to make your application just prior to topsoil temperatures averaging above 55 degrees consistently over a few days. This is the temperature that crabgrass will begin to germinate, so timing is critical to ensure control. If you have existing crabgrass, you will have to make a post-emergent herbicide application for control. Some examples of post-emergent crabgrass herbicides includes BASF's Drive Accelerate, Quali-pro's Quinclorac, and PBI Gordon's Q4+. To learn more about managing weeds as well as other landscape and irrigation topics, sign up for one of our live seminars. Or you can learn more by stopping into your local Ewing branch or visiting us online at ewingirrigation.com.